to me in my last church, Brother Michael. You don't know what happened to me in my last church.
Amen.
I have three words for you. Get over it.
Amen.
Get over it. Why? Because there's healing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And there ain't no hurt going to be greater than God's ability to heal. Amen. And because you have scars, let me tell you something. Hallelujah, because there are no mature soldiers without scars.
Amen. That's right.
There are no soldiers without scars. And yet still, what is the mark of a warrior today? The mark of a warrior is very simple. Some people, when the sounds of the battle go, they grab up the little bitty children and run away from the battle. But it is the warrior who snatches up his sword, who grabs his shield and runs to the battle. Amen. Let me tell you something. The lighthouse is being built right where it is. There's a purpose for it here. We are here to, amen, be a lighthouse to a lost and dying community of people that desperately need a little hope, that need some light to shine. When the battle goes on and the battle is raging and I'm watching these children, bring them here. I want them here, amen, because I'm going to run towards the battle. Praise God. So the Bible says this, verse 28, let him that stole steal no more.
Amen.
How do you steal? How do you steal? How do you steal? Stealing is taking that something that doesn't belong to you. How much of God's money have you stolen? How much of your neighbor's stuff have you taken? How many things have you ever borrowed and not returned? Amen. Just don't do it anymore. Let them work with their hands the thing which is good, that he will may have to give to him that needeth. Poor little Matthew, I got such a kick out of him. We've been going through some giving stuff, and I'm discussing where my giving is. You see, I don't care whether you tithe or not. I believe that God will put upon your heart that which it is to give. And let a person so give as they are directed, as they purpose in their own heart. Amen. So you're free. You're free. You're free. You know, I'm not preaching tithing. I don't worry about tithing. Tithing won't touch what I give, praise God. I'm going to give like I want. Man, if my income would just be where my giving level is, I'd be all right. Amen. And that's all right. So I give and I praise God and I praise God and I give. And somebody shows up and says, well, here, these shingles are half price. My $4,000 worth of shingles turned into $1,700. Somebody bless me. The $3,000 in which to do a roof, a brother showed up and said, hey, if you get some kids, haul some shingles up to me, I'll come do it. We'll knock it out for $1,000. That $3,000 job was done for $1,000. Amen.
Amen.
I just get blessed. I get blessed. I get blessed. Amen. You want to have some fun? Pull up the Sonic and say, I'm paying for the person behind me. No people. There's a drive-thru at Sonic. Okay, yeah. This you give. The one thing you think I'm wrong about, this you pick up on. Did you hear that part about not judging one another anymore? Hey, okay.
Thank you, Kendra.
Have some fun. I got a kick out of Matthew. Matthew was praying about this, and he said, Dad, I feel led to do this, and I feel led to give this. And you know, what do you think of that? I said, you do whatever you think, because what you reap, you're going to sow. What you reap, you're going to sow. That's the way it is with giving. So he goes to the movie theater. And a man decides to pay for everything that he's ordered at the snack stand. Paid it all. Why are we giving these hamburgers away? Why are we having a free garage sale? Because Jesus paid it all. And all to him I owe. Amen. Come on. I am so blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed by the best. I'm blessed everywhere I put my foot. Everywhere I go is blessed. The favor of God operates in my life. No matter what's going on, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm purely blessed. I'm blessed by the Father above. I'm so blessed. I just believe if your cup runneth over, we should be in the splashing business.
Amen.
Amen.
How many of you have stuff in your sheds, in your garage, that you, this has value, it really does have value. You don't want to throw this away, but I ain't touched it in 10 years. I ain't fiddled with it in 15 years. I ain't used it in 5 years. Bless somebody. Amen. I just believe that if you give away a Volkswagen, somebody just might give you a Cadillac, you know? Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Let me hit this one again because I got teenagers in here. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouths. Speak that which is good to the use of building up. You see. How many believe that children really believe what you tell them?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't always work that way. My little brother, you tell him it's hot on the stove, he has to touch it to find out. Amen? That was my brother. Matthew's laughing because that's the same way as his brother. Just yesterday, we decided to really splurge. So we went to the wagon master, and out come this skillet, and the waitress says, "Don't touch the skillet, it's hot." At which Cameron goes, "Yeah, pretty hot." Yeah. But if you tell the child that they're dumb, you don't understand it, but there's a part of them that believes it that begins to hinder them. Amen. You don't tell somebody that you're an idiot. Believe me, I had a wife who did it to me for years. You idiot. Finally, I looked at her one day and I said, "Don't you ever call me that again because it's wrong and I'm not an idiot." Most of the time she said, when she was joking, she would call me a moron, and I go, "Moron than off, though, baby, you know I." But the Bible says what we speak should be edifying, and the word edifying means building up. We should be building up one another. It means you should find something good to say, because once you start talking about somebody's good attributes, right, it becomes very easy, right? This is actually a fine young man, right? This girl is a sweetheart. All you got to do is hang around her a little while and realize that she is a sweetheart, right? And she's so social. She's like a little magpie. She would talk to you, amen, name a subject, and she's off to the races. If you ever want to have a conversation with her, ask her one question and just sit down. That's okay. She'll carry that into the conversation from then on. She's a sweetheart, right? This lady right here, all right, 9 kids. She hadn't killed any of them. Need I say more? I believe if I had 9 kids, I would have at least eaten one of them. See?
Wow.
Bible says this, verse 30, "And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby you are sealed unto the day of redemption." Stop grieving the Holy Spirit. How do you know when you're grieving the Holy Spirit? Because the Holy Spirit is not your conscience, even though you sometimes mistake Him for that. The Holy Spirit, when He's grieved, is the one who goes, "Oh, you shouldn't have said that." And when the Spirit of God does that to you, you know what you need to do? You need to stop immediately and go, "I shouldn't have said that. That was the wrong thing to say. I'm sorry. Please forgive me." Because if you grieve the Spirit of God enough, you will quench the Spirit of God, the Bible says. Have you ever been in a church service where the song service is going pretty well, everything's going pretty good, you feel the Spirit of God beginning to move in the midst of the people, and then the preacher gets up and is quenched? Or you walk in and you feel like it almost quenches you because you walked into the wrong place. You ever felt full of the Holy Ghost and walked in the wrong place? Oh my God. I walked in church one time, about 10, 15 minutes before services started, and the ushers didn't open the door. They didn't speak to us. We had to push past the ushers just to get inside. We found a little place to sit down. Nobody offered us a bulletin. Everybody was looking all around at us and looking at us, you know, after a while, I'm like, "Geez, did somebody forget their deodorant? Did I not brush my teeth? You know, are we dressed all wrong?" And probably 5 minutes more services started. I look over to Linda, and they're getting ready to get started. I'm like, "We're out of here. Let's go. Any place that's going to quench the Spirit of God, I don't want to be." How many of you just want to go someplace where the Spirit of God is?
Amen.
Well, let me tell you something. The Spirit of God is with you. If He comes with you, He's there. Everywhere I go, the Spirit of God is. Everywhere I go, the Spirit of God is. Which is really interesting because the Holy Ghost either draws you in like a magnet or repels you like a magnet. Which is why I love it when I preach, people walk the aisle, in or out, but they move. Some people, they see me in Walmart and run me down. Hey, run. Other people see me in Walmart and they don't see me. They go around the other aisle.
True.
Amen. Don't grieve the Holy Spirit anymore. Let all bitterness, let me tell you something, I'm about wrapping up. Let all bitterness, say, let it go, let it go, let it go. Older you get, the more bitter you become if you're not careful. Bitterness begins where cancer grows. Let all bitterness go. Bitterness affects your body chemistry and throws off your pH balance to where it leads to shingles, it leads to cancer. You got to let the bitterness go. Bitterness begins with unforgiveness. You better forgive them. How should I forgive them, Pastor? Exactly in the way that Jesus forgave you. Forgive them. Let all bitterness cease. Let all wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. It's time to grow up. Sometimes in order to grow up, you have to shut up. Anybody felt that way? I'm about to speak, so it's time for me to shut up. And when I sit there and I pray about it for a while, and I feel like the Spirit of God has now loosed me, sometimes it's time to speak up. Sometimes it's time to shut up. You better get the two right. For me, when I walk away and 12 hours later, I'm angrier than I was when I shut up. I've prayed about it. I've covered it. My wife, my children can tell you what it's like when I come back. I got something to say to you now. Talked to a lady who worked for her pastor, and I said, "Do you love your pastor?" "Yes." "Do you know how to shut up and not talk about your pastor?" "Yes, I do." "He's a human being. He has errors. He has flaws. He has faults. And I don't ever repeat none of it to nobody. I don't say nothing." "You love him enough to shut up?" "Yes, sir, I do." "Do you love him enough to speak up?" "What do you mean?" "It means he's surrounded by people who will shut up. That means he needs somebody that will speak up." "Pastor, I think you're wrong. Can I ask you about this? Can we talk about it a little bit?" Amen. Let me tell you something. This ain't no dictatorship here. The body of Christ. No big eyes, no little views. Amen? Maybe I get to be the under-captain. Maybe I get to be the director of the orchestra. Thank you, Kevin. Okay? But this is Team Jesus. Amen? This is Team Jesus. We come together, we're on the same team. Everybody speaks up. Everybody's free. Everybody's valuable. The Bible says this, "And be ye kind one to another." I want this place to be different from most churches I've ever seen. Because I've been to churches where they will hug you and smile. But it doesn't mean they love you. Okay? Let me tell you something. When a shark smiles at you, it don't mean he's being friendly. It means he thinks you'll take a great big bite out of you. Not every Christian that hugs you, loves you. Sometimes they're just trying to get just close enough to knife you in the back.
True.
But if here, this is a place where we don't judge one another. How many of y'all got enough trouble trying to judge yourself? Hey, that's half the hands. Not interested in being honest with me. Come on, let's do it for real. How many of you have enough trouble judging yourself? All right? Keeping yourself straight. You really want to be responsible for anybody else?
No.
Right. Why don't you love them? Don't judge them. Be kind and tender-hearted. Sometimes when the Spirit of God tells you to say something to them, it's time to speak up. It's time to speak up. When you speak up in love, come on. Y'all hear what I'm saying? One little 16-year-old girl started showing up at church, and boy, was she dressed inappropriately. lead and run a little children's church. And by the way, we're praying.